everyone, it's Connie. I'm jumping into my own little speed paint here to talk about the context behind this birthday drawing for Alan Price 2024. It's pretty self-explanatory because, yes, I am drawing him with various instruments he's played over the years, and not just the keyboard instruments, the grand piano and the Vox Continental. Now, yeah, we've seen him play those quite a bit, and I've drawn him with a Vox Continental quite a bit. Grand piano, not as much. I usually draw him with electric organs when I do draw him with a keyboard. This was my first time drawing a full-on grand piano. Well, at least from this angle. I did a different one with him and Eric in front of a grand piano, but never one from this side, which is why I changed the angle and perspective compared to my initial sketch. I was getting a little ambitious, but I'm like, no, I'm gonna do something a little bit more head-on and easy to understand. So yeah, I fixed that sketch. And again, Vox Continental, I've drawn him with plenty of times. But then the bass guitar, an animal's lore, I'm sure a lot of you know, but he actually played the bass initially in one of the groups he was in, the Thomas Headley Trio, I think it was called, and that was what Eric first saw him on, but Eric obviously thought he was very good on piano too, so encouraged him to pursue that. But yeah, he plays the bass quite a bit, and he plays the guitar too. You see him in a few Georgie Fame videos in the early 70s where he's playing like rhythm guitar and things. But yeah, Alan can indeed play string instruments, and technically the piano's a string instrument if you really want to get technical. But yeah, he could play those. And then the more unique ones, we got the melodica, which is what he was playing earlier in the video where I was drawing. That little harmonica looking thing with the keyboard on it, and the sound in the background that I was not wanting to speak over. I'm not gonna speak over Eric, I promise. Yeah, that was the melodica. He plays that on the Animals' first ever EP, that was Pretty Thing playing in the background, and then he also played it on Big Boss Man on the same EP. Very good. I enjoy that quite a lot. And John Steele confirms it in the Animals, one of the Animals' biographies, The Newcastle's Rising Suns. John Steele confirms that that is indeed Alan Price playing that little melodica. And then, you'll see it in the speed paint in a second, but it is a vibraphone. He played the vibes at one point. And again, this is a interesting anecdote because I don't think there's any actual recorded music of him playing the vibes. I don't think. There might be some deep cuts somewhere that I have not found yet. But in a couple of choice articles from like Music Echo and things in 1964, Eric mentions that Alan plays the vibes. And I'm like, whoa, because here's some Connie lore. I actually used to play instruments quite a bit, and the specific instruments I played were mallet instruments, like the xylophone and the marimba. I never played the vibraphone, I'm afraid, but it's the closest I feel to Alan, musically speaking, because we both played similar instruments, sort of. So I wanted to draw him with a vibraphone. So thank you for the lore, Eric. I appreciate it deeply. And in general, I appreciate Alan Price. You're gonna probably be reading about it in the description of this video and all the various posts I make everywhere about Happy Birthday Alan Price 2024. He's the best. He is my favorite musician. He makes me so happy. He gives me the very happy serotonin. Thank you, Alan Price, for everything. And thank you for being so nice to me when we met in March. Yes, I met Alan Price, and he was amazing. Thank you, Alan, and I hope you see this drawing sometime soon, because I need to ask you questions about the vibraphone. Anyway, yes, happy birthday, Alan Price, and thank you for changing my life with your music, fundamentally changing my life and making my life so much better with you and your music and the Animals. Thank you, thank you, thank you.